रिस्पेक्टेड भगवंत खूबा जी, ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर फॉर स्टेट केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर्स न्यू एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी, डिस्टिंग्विश्ड गेस्ट एंड माय फेलो पैनलिस्ट एंड ऑफकोर्स टीम आईसीएम, आप सबको नवरात्रि की शुभकामनाएं एंड थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू शेयर माई परस्पेक्टिव इन दिस डेकोरेटिव फोरम. एट द आउटसेट आई वुड लाइक टू से टू थिंग्स. वन इज I am extremely glad and pleased to see presence of Bhagwant ji since the beginning of this event, and this also endorses the perspective of how keen Government of India is to ensure that chemical industry by and large is successful. And second, I think I should also appreciate Praveen, you and your team for the efforts that they have taken in bringing together the nebula of shining stars from our chemical industry together. I welcome you all and I trust you all are safe and fully vaccinated. Since I am equally excited to hear everyone and especially the galaxy of industry leaders that are speaking today, I will try to restrict my voice to less than 4 minutes. While I was reflecting on this topic and theme for today, next gen, I thought it will be pertinent to review what is the next gen potential for our next generation and how do we make India an attractive destination for the coming generations which will take the baton forward from us. So there are three areas which I would like to emphasize. One is what kind of an opportunity is lying ahead of us. It's very important to address it. The second is what could be the potential of leveraging that opportunity in a very differentiated and a unique manner. And third and most important, which my fellow panelists have already emphasized on, is circularity of doing business going forward. So I'll start with an opportunity. And I was reading a recent review with a leading consulting firm that mentioned that the Indian chemical story is one of outperformance and promise. And I completely advocate this statement. Our industry now has been a consistent value creator. The chemical industry remains an attractive hub of opportunities, even though we have been in an environment of global uncertainty of current times, right? And I think global trends and patterns have thrown a very interesting opportunity for the chemical companies and the industry in India. And this is probably exactly where policies play a very important role in the way chemical companies in India will prioritize and also tap that differentiated value creating potential, which in my opinion could shape the future of this chemical industry for generations. And Bhagwant ji, I cannot but agree that the vision that our Honorable Prime Minister has conceived to make India self-reliant and Atmanirbhar is absolutely the need of the hour. And I think in order for our industry to capture that pole position globally, I guess the sector must emerge as an integrated and a differentiated value player where we should envision and build our capabilities to offer an integrated downstream product or solution. But this can only be possible if we are able to strengthen our upstream capabilities. And consequently, while we do this, I am pretty much confident that we will be able to create a very unique value proposition, which will be extremely hard to compete with. I guess if we look at the trade disruptions today that have erupted around the world, and it is also giving a very good opportunity for our industry to tap upon. And in my opinion, we should seize this with agility before someone else does it. And this certainly needs a collective teamwork from industry, from trade, and of course from the government. And I guess production linked incentives, which have been announced for various industry, could really usher in efficiency and effectiveness that will help us become Atmanirbhar and more liberal in our and largely open in our mindset. I think it will also phrase us with a very unique position, which we can then transform into an attractive global hub for innovation of new molecules. And I think there are, I have never been an advocate of free lunches in this world. I guess the way the incentive plan has been set, it also signifies the effort that the industry needs to make equally to make sure that we are successful and we make our country successful. And that's what is unique about this program. It needs to be used and leveraged well so that we are not only building a robust and a strong foundation for our country, but we are also building a very strong value proposition for the rest of the industries to really emulate from what we have been able to do. And there are some classical examples, I would say, in India, where we are already seeing successes coming out of differentiation. And when we talk about molecules, it leads me to research and development, which I think is the most critical part of differentiation. And hence, I feel that there are areas such as research and development, which should become a very important part of our focus and also government's focus in coming days. I guess we will only be Atmanirbhar if we are able to encourage setting up of more research and development centers across the country. We really have an unmatched and a superior talent, in my opinion, in our country. And I'm very proud of working and having been associated with some brightest minds and scientists during my work tenure. We should encourage global and Indian testing companies to set up state-of-the-art capabilities, which to a large extent is also going to help the SME industry in India. And I'll give you an example. I speak to many budding entrepreneurs who are working on breakthrough technologies, but for them to commercialize it takes time. And it's not because of their ideation, but it's because of sometimes the research infrastructure in our country as far as testing capabilities is concerned is limited. Therefore, if you have to send a prototype out of India, you have to wait for at least 6 weeks for the results to come. And then if it fails, another 6 weeks. And I think if we are able to set some value system here, it could actually accelerate us into the different orbit. And I guess the plan to set up chemicals clusters is definitely a step in the right direction. It will yield probably even better dividends. And I think Kapil mentioned that if we are connecting roads and relatively world-class supply chain infrastructure around these capabilities in chemical clusters. So we can produce molecules, we can be upstream, but when we have to distribute these products across the nation to different clusters of factories, we really need a state-of-the-art facility. And I think this Bombay-Delhi corridor is really exciting me. And I guess coming years, we should see such transitions happening in our country. The last part is on sustainability. As we pursue to do more, I guess we should also endeavor to use lesser resources. It does not end only with using of lesser resources. I guess it's also our responsibility to reuse what we produce. And this will essentially complete that goal. Sustainability, in my opinion, is becoming an imperative. It's not a buzzword anymore. And with various stakeholders are placing a premium on it. And I guess as we go in that journey of growing ourselves, we also need to ensure that we are cognizant of our responsibilities that planet Earth has put on us. With that, thank you so much for inviting me. And I wish you all the best for this event.